In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Good morning. His gospel, Jesus, and his farewell message to us wants to give us peace in our life. We pray that that peace may live in our hearts. You were sent to heal the contrite, Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy. For us at the right hand of the Father, Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, to restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, grant your people constantly in faith and hope that we may never doubt the promises of which we have learned from you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In those days, some Jews from Antioch and Iconium arrived and went over the crowds. They stoned Paul and dragged him out of the city, supposing that he was dead. But when the disciples gathered around him, he got up and entered the city. On the following day, he left with Barnabas for Derbe. After they had proclaimed the good news to that city and made a considerable number of disciples, they returned to Lystra and to Iconium and to Antioch. They strengthened the spirits of the disciples and exhorted them to persevere in the faith, saying, "It is necessary for us to undergo many hardships to enter the kingdom of God." They appointed presbyters for them in each church, and with prayer and fasting, commended them to the Lord in whom they had put their faith. Then they traveled through Pisidia and reached Pamphylia. After proclaiming the word at Perga, they went down to Attalia. From there, they sailed to Antioch, where they had been commended to the grace of God for the work they had now accomplished. And when they arrived, they called the church together and reported what God had done with them and how he had opened the door of faith to the Gentiles. Then they spent no little time with the disciples. The word of the Lord. Your friends make known, O Lord, the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Let all your works give you thanks, O Lord, and let your faithful ones bless you. Let them discourse of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your might. Your presence, O Lord, the splendor of your kingdom. making known to men your might and the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Your kingdom is a kingdom for all ages, and your dominion endures through all generations. May my mouth speak the praise of the Lord, and may all flesh bless his holy name forever and ever.
Gospel we take is taken from the 14th chapter of John's Gospel, and chapters 14 to 17 in John's Gospel are called the discourse, the final discourse of Jesus. Jesus knows he's ascending to the Father, and he wants to leave us special messages before he goes. And today's special message is simply peace. The Hebrew word is shalom. And the word shalom can mean hello, goodbye, but more importantly, it means fullness of salvation. That's what that word really means, fullness of salvation. So I was talking to one of our parishioners recently about some psychological things that were going on, and she's a psychologist, and she said, you know, if you veer from the beliefs and the teachings of Jesus Christ, your life seems to get more unpeaceful, more troubled. That peace comes from living a right way of life. You know, people want to have a life of no problems, no stress, right? Where's that? Okay. It's not in the world, it's someplace else in heaven. So Jesus says, I'm offering you this gift of tranquility and peace that you can't find in the world. You can't find it in money, power, sex, control, addictions. You're not going to find it there. He says, it's only one way and one place for peace in our life, and that's having God in the center of our lives. That's the gift that Jesus wants to give us. Peace, tranquility, and union with him will bring us the greatest happiness in life. As we celebrate peace and shalom in our life, we pray for our church's leaders and all God's people. We pray to the Lord. We pray for peace and harmony among peoples and nations. We pray to the Lord. We pray that God's peace and shalom may live in our hearts and in the lives of our family members. We pray to the Lord.
Peace in our families, in our world, in our state.
pray that your Son may live in our hearts this day and give us the peace and the tranquility that we seek so much. Through Christ our Lord. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exalted Church, and as you've given her cause with such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit to perpetual happiness. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, all times to claim you, O Lord, but at times above all to laud you that more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and pleads our cause before you. He is our sacrificial victim who dies no more, a lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers and the angelic hosts sing together then in hymn of your glory as we acclaim. Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. Eat holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, on supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Our mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come. And for us, we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, and all clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, our glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you always. These Mass from Josiane Curie, deceased. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those who are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of your resurrection, through Christ our Lord. Lord be with you. Lord God, bless us all, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.